All right, we're looking and gonna try to play Gipf, GIPF. So there's like 7 or 8, probably more games in his family of games. So this is the first one, I believe. There's 3 different types you could play on here. And it was basic, classic, and tournament, maybe? I don't know. Standard? I don't know. Okay. Certain versions you should play. We're playing the first one. Basic. All right. Okay. The first player to create a situation where their opponent has no more pieces in their reserve or no more GIF pieces on the board wins the game. So keep in mind, make sure to always have at least one piece in reserve and always at least one GIF piece on the board. How would you pronounce that? GIF? GIF? G-I-P-F? GIF? All right, pieces. The players start with 18 pieces in reserve each. Pieces in reserve are pieces of your own color that are not in play. A GIF piece is 2 pieces stacked upon one another. All right. The board. There are 24 dots at the edge of the pattern on the board. Dots are not part of the play area. Okay. They serve to position a piece before bringing it into play. The play area is made up of 37 spots, intersections. Only the pieces covering a spot are part of the game. The lines indicate in which direction pieces may be moved. The start. The board is empty. Both players have 18 pieces in reserve. The first move. Draw lots for your color. If you draw white, you begin. The first move must be a GIMP piece. Take 2 pieces out of your reserve and stack them on top of each other. Put the double piece on any of the black dots and next push it onto an adjacent spot. You may move a piece only 1 spot at a time, never 2 or more, then your opponent brings a GIMP piece into play. All right, easy enough so far. That's what it looks like. Okay. There we go. Alright. I like the board. That's pretty cool. Moving other pieces. Both players have made 1 move. When introducing a piece, you can either move it to an empty spot or to an already occupied spot. If the spot is already occupied, it must first be cleared. The piece occupying it, regardless of its color, must be moved to the next spot on the line. That spot would also be occupied, and this piece also moves over 1 spot. Next, push the piece onto the cleared spot. And the diagram and black move over white. So I play board games with a friend, one of my other friends, and he said he usually just zones out when I'm reading the rules and then tries to figure out what we're doing. Alright, I've heard that. Introducing single pieces. Both players may introduce as many GIF pieces as they want until they bring a single piece into play. When learning the game, we advise you play with 3 or 4 GIF pieces. Can you hear me? Okay. you're pretty quiet. That's better. That's better, yeah. In the diagram, black just played a single piece on spot D2. Alright. And may introduce no more GIMP pieces during the rest of the game. White may still do so until they, too, play the first single piece. So it says 3 or 4 is what they advise. 2 restrictions. A piece already in play may not be moved as a separate piece. A piece or more pieces on the board can only be moved by introducing a new piece. All the pieces in play may be pushed by both players, black and white. Pieces single and given pieces. And number two, when all the spots on the line are occupied, if you cannot play in the direction of that line, if you would, you would push a piece out of the game at the opposite site, and that is not allowed. Okay. Recycling and capturing pieces. Very simple. As soon as four single pieces of your color are lined up on adjacent spots, dots don't count. It is compulsory to take them from the board. Moreover, not only must these four pieces be removed, but also the pieces that form a direct extension of them. The pieces of your own color are returned to your reserve. The pieces of the other color are captured, thus lost to your opponent. Okay. Gipf piece in play. A Gipf piece counts for just one piece. The only difference between a single piece and a Gipf piece, no matter the color, is that a Gipf piece may be left on the board when they are part of a row that must be removed. If you remove a Gipf piece of your color, you may not introduce it as a Gipf piece anymore. If you already started playing with a single piece, you must split the Gipf piece into two single pieces. Force capture. Taking pieces from the board is not a move in itself. It's always a result of a move, either your move or an opponent's. In the diagram, white played b1 e4 and completed a row of black four pieces. Black must take the three single pieces from the board and decide what he'll do with Gipf piece. He must then make a move. Now black has more pieces in reserve, but white's advantage is that black has less pieces on the board. That's weaker for him. Alright, rows. It may occur that two rows are lined up at the same time. If these rows don't intersect, both must be removed. If they do intersect, the player may choose which row they'll take. If there would be a Gipf piece on the spot of the intersection, white may first take one row, leave the Gipf piece and the board, then next take the second row. Alright. When a situation occurs which both players must remove pieces, the player who caused the situation goes first. Row of four Gipf pieces. It may happen that four or even more Gipf pieces of one color are lined up. In this case, you may leave them on their spots or you may take one or more from the board. If you decide to leave them on the board and they are still lined up when it's your turn again, then you may again choose what to do before you'll make the move. And if they're lined up having played, after your move. All right, end of the game. There are two ways of winning. You must capture your opponent's last Gipf piece, or you must exhaust their reserve. As said in the beginning, a player who has either no move, no more Gipf pieces on the board, or has no piece left to make a move, loses the game. I just repeated it twice. I don't know why I did that. Remarks. This is the last thing. Don't misinterpret the aim of the game. You can only win by capturing the opponent's pieces, not by returning your own pieces repeatedly from the board to the reserve. So yeah, getting four on the row. Okay. A tie is not possible. The first player to run out of pieces loses the game, even if the other player, too, would run out of pieces on the next turn. And players should always be able to see how many pieces the opponent has left in their reserve. Leave them clearly visible next to the board. We'll see. All right. Any questions? All right. It doesn't give us a number of our pieces left, but you're up first, though. Nice. So, okay, never mind. Sorry. How did you push it? What did you do there?
All right, let's move on. Just clicked on one of them.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Look at you. So you can't, you don't push each other off the board, do you?
I'm not sure.
I don't think you do. I think it's a... I think it just stopped there.
Find out.
Well, not on this move. So yeah, there's other games based on this concept or something, or in this family of games. Oh, look at you. Are all these double pieces or are these single pieces?
I think they're just single pieces.
Okay, I think the ones that are originally on the board were the double pieces, but I can't really tell the difference. It's still your turn. I don't know if... Okay, yeah.
I'm thinking about it.
I saw you put something down, I thought, so... I'm not seeing the number in our reserve. think this is going to be a good move. I don't know if it's going to happen. All right. Not much. What's going on here? All right. I captured one of yours, I think. Okay, so can you push these off or no? No, you can't. You can't push things off. So I don't know which ones are the four or three or four stones that we're trying to capture. They all look the same, right? Nice. Oh, it's still your turn. Wow, look at you. Look at that. A double. Yeah, so I'm not sure which four I was just captured here, because that is the goal of the game. And they all look the same. I don't know which ones are mine either. Oh, it's just the pieces on the board. So you either have to have a piece on the board, like if all your pieces are captured, then. Yeah, your reserve or your or the board. You have to be able to do both. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Could it be? Ooh.
No, sir.
Oh, what It's showing blue dots on them. Oh, there we go. Okay.
Yeah, you got one of mine, but I'm still in the game.
Yeah, I thought that was going to be the last one. Nice. Yeah, I still haven't seen a counter on our pieces we have. I think we're close, but we capture by the same, I think.
I haven't seen one either. I don't know how they're supposed to, like, keep track of how many we have or what. But
yeah, I should have done that for sure. Oh man. Ooh. Huh, I was thinking I had a push, but he just plays bad. Aaron, I wish I knew how many we had left. I think you've captured more of mine now. Ah, oh, damn. Yeah, well, right afterwards. bounce back. Game's been going on a while. I don't know if you're gonna see that or not. I still don't know how many, like, we've got down to one, but I still don't know. I guess it's less than four, right? I mean, we like get back four. This took a lot longer than I was expecting it was going to take. And it continues.
What?
So the and it continues. Ooh. That's not good. I don't think I... Yeah, I can't do it here. Well, I think you'd win after this turn.
Probably.
I don't have any more in my reserve. Nice. All right. Good game. Fun overall. A little longer than I was expecting. Very fun. Gipf. All right.